see the Turnator. The Turnator is a very strong toy radio control car with big wheels, and both sides are working. It is very nice for little children to have fun with this. And the remote controller is driving the left wheel only, or the right wheel only. So it is easy to make a sharp turn like a 360. And it's very good as a first car to go to the radio controlled world. Actually, this was my very first car 2 years ago. And in this video, I'm going to show you the basic of the radio hobby. The basic thing that you can do is change the radio the battery interface. So let's look at, this is my currently modified version of the XT60. And one of the issue is that, so here you have a change version that I have already done, so you can see it. This is a standard XT60 interface. However, when you buy it, it comes with a stupid non-standard connector like this, and you do not have a lot of wire, so it is quite inconvenient. So this is for stupid children who do not understand plus and minus, and it is impossible to mix them with this little shape, which are different. But in fact, the standard XT60 has also this behavior. It is not possible to interchange the plus and the minus. The problem is most of the battery, when you have a lot of different cars, you want to have the same interface for the battery, so you can exchange the battery between the cars. So we will see together in this model I've already opened how to change this little wire. So you can in fact remove this screw, the four screw. It is not very easy because you need a long screwdriver, and once you remove this screw, you can go inside the model. So here you see clearly the two different motors. This is interesting to see. By the way, the radio receiver is located here. Radio receiver on the ESC, which is driving the two motors on the other side here. And this is a motor, brushed motors. And we will see together how to change the red and black wire, which are linked to the battery connector, then solder it. To do this, I'm going to use some wire, 16 AVG wire, not less AVG. As you remember, if you downgrade the AVG, the less the number of the AVG, the bigger the circumferences. For example, 12 AVG is very big, and 16 AVG is just sufficient to plug this X. And the direct added value to change the battery connector is that when you are standardizing your battery pack with the XT60, you can easily interchange the different batteries. So here you see different batteries, but all of them are sharing the same XT60 connector. Little subtlety, as a convention, all the battery should have a female connector and not a male. As a convention, the source of energy is a female connector and not a male, because if you have a male, you have two pins of wire which gets out, and you can easily create a shortcut with a transversal bar like this. So here, if I have a transversal bar, I will not create a shortcut, and this is the reason why all the batteries are using female connector. Also, another reason why you can interchange a connector is you can use a standard charger, and with this XT60 connector, I am using a professional high quality charger. So this is in fact the existing battery which is sold by the provider Carrera for the Turnator. And here you can see, so there is a little difference in different batteries is that here you see this is Li-ion. Li-ion. So you can interchange a battery because the nominal voltage, 7.4 volt, is the same between the different batteries. So here I have four different batteries. Some are Li-ion and these are LiPo. The difference is that the cutoff, the low voltage is different between the two, but when they are charged, the Li-ion goes to the maximum of 8.2 volt, the LiPo go to 8.4 volt, but you can still interchange them, and I have tried the LiPo version in the Tornator and it is not an issue. The only drawback is that you must be aware that some models have a low cutoff, and with a very low cutoff, some LiPo batteries are a little more sensitive and you can damage them by going too low in the voltage. However, I have tested the Tornator and it self cuts off with LiPo battery, and the LiPo battery is still usable after, and you can reload it without any issue. So that's why you can, when you have made some experiment, exchange the connectors and you can exchange the batteries as soon as they have the same S. So here this is 2S Li-ion to a nominal voltage of 7.4 volt, and this is 2S LiPo battery, and the difference in the voltage is not a lot. You must be aware that the manufacturer is writing down that you should not use a third party battery. Why? Because they want to sell their own battery. And the important fact is, as a technical user, you should just look at the voltage. If the voltage is 7.4 volts, you can use another battery with the same connector, like this one, which is written here. 7.4 volt, 1100 milliamp hour. So the milliamp hour is not an issue about the intercompatibility. The milliamp hour number just indicates how long the battery can last. The more the milliamp hour, the longer the battery. The voltage should be exactly the same, 7.4 volt, but one more time, what is displayed here, 7.4 volt, is the nominal voltage. Once this is loaded after a reloader, the charger has finished its job, the nominal voltage of LiPo battery is 8.4 volt and not 7.4, and the nominal voltage of Li-ion battery is about 8.2 volt. And you see here, this battery is very with a lot of more autonomy, 3300 milliamp hour. So this is even more than this big version. More than twice this one. So this is also the added value to interchange battery. You can have other battery less expensive bought on Chinese website, go in your car. Other subtlety, be careful, this LiPo IMAX B6 charger can charge LiPo or Li-ion on other battery. You should be aware how to set up this thing. There is a difference in the setup to load a LiPo battery and to load a Li-ion battery. The charger must be properly configured. If you are reloading a Li-ion battery in the LiPo mode, you can break it. This is important. If you are recharging a Li-ion battery when this charger is set in a LiPo mode, you can overflow your battery and this will not be functional anymore. It will not necessarily burn, but it will be out of service. To open the Tornator, use a normal screwdriver which looks to be a PH2. Four screws here, 1, 2, 3, 4. After this, there is this rolling here, bullet, which are acting like blocking the shell. So you just press to remove it from the shell like this. And at the bottom, same thing. Oops. So the screws are there. So four screws. And here you have the naked Tornator with the wire for the battery. On the other side, same thing. You can we must remove it to access for the other side, to access the part of the other part of the wire of the battery. And same thing, you must go a little hard on this stuff because, okay, so it is unclipped, and here you have the beautiful thing. So apartment for the battery, battery wire black and red, which are coming out here. Switch on off here. All the wires go to the receiver, which is here, ESC receiver embedded, which is a proprietary to Carrera. You cannot modify it. Then two motors, brushed motors here. So the connector is there. It is linked to two wires, red and black. And the two wires go to the other side of the model. The two wires are linked to this place here. Here. So there is a little node here to avoid the user to pull too much of the wire like this. And because I like to be able to use the connector still, I will cut them not at the bottom but in the middle of the wire. Maybe, or so I do not cut here because maybe I will want to use a connector for something else, but I'm going to cut at the very bottom here. Good. The wires for the battery are now freed. I just need to remove some plastic before connecting the new wire, 16 AVG. So the current existing wire are 18 AVG, and I'm going to extend them with some 16 AVG. So what is important is to have lower AVG instead of small, instead of bigger, because one more time, the smaller the AVG, the bigger the wire. So this is 16, and this is 18. So this is compatible. So I'm using this tool to remove the plastic, and then we'll connect them. To connect them, solder them, and once the solder has been made, I have here some heat shrink that will be used to isolate all the stuff. Now that it has been, it is ready, I can use this heating machine. So this is a TAC Life heating machine to heat the heat shrink. And is working very nicely. Just check the position of the heat shrink before fixing it. And the heat shrink, when they are heat, they are shrinking, as the name indicates. And this little shape here is to optimize the airflow to have a better heat. The battery connector which should come here, so the battery connector will be connected there and go in the other side of the vehicle. There is here a switch. This is a switch to put the on off system of the car, and you see the ground. So the black wire is connected to this switch. When you are switching on, normally the light system is on. You see a little red wire here. You see here blue and white wire which are connected to the same motor, and the other motor is linked with some brown and orange wire. So these are brushed motors because they are connected with two wires. And below this you have the ESC, the Electro Speed Controller, where of course you see here the red and the black wire to give the voltage, and so red and black for the battery. The black is prolonged by these two wires. On the output of the ESC is these four wires, brown, orange, blue and white for the two motors. This is how this car works, and this is the difference with this car and with the other cars is that you do not have direction servo. Normally the output of the system should have one single motor and one steering servo to go to the right and the left. Here the difference is that there is two motor with two electro speed controller. So it is important to understand how it is interesting to understand how the vehicle is connected and how it's working. Now what remains to do is to select exactly the distance of the wire I want. Put the other side, maybe create a little node here to have the same protection, and then connect this. So I have cut the correct length of the wire, and I'm going to put this back in the hole. By the way, before going in the other side, I want to ask you, if you are looking at this video, if you know why this is for this plate, write me down in the comments. Because I do not understand why these plates are so long here. They are like stabilizing the motor, but from my understanding, these two screws should be enough. So why do we have this thing here, and why do we have this thing here? Explain me in the comments if you understand why, and also why there is, so maybe the plastic is for the water, to avoid some water to go there, but it is not so much protection. But yes, I do not get the utility of this metal shape here.
After the screw, obviously, hein. The screw is important to fix the motor, but I mean this part and this part. To solder the XT60 connector, I am using this tool, which is quite little and very practical. I have slightly modified it with this two handle here, and here I can put here like this and squeeze it. So now it is fixed, and it is very important to have this kind of thing because it's very convenient that the part do not move at all. And one of the difficulty when you are a beginner to solder new connector is that you should have a tool like this to fix the endpoint. It's quite difficult to solder without a system which has a fixation like this. So before putting the shell back, let's make a test to check that the electronic is working. To do a test, what I have, instead of putting a battery that I could corrupt if there is some problem, I am using a dedicated transformer which outputs a 7.4 volt, which is the same size, same thing as a battery. And I have put a female XT60 connector on this. So I can easily simulate a battery with this system. So I'm connecting my fake battery, then I connect my fake battery to the car. Good. Now I switch on the car. So now I have my receiver on my car which are bound. Let's make a test to check if everything is working. Good. So everything is nicely connected, which is not a big surprise because this is a very easy job. But at least I can now close the full car, and I am sure that the wiring is correctly done, and I will not have to open it again if I made a mistake, because I didn't make any mistake here.
Vous pouvez comme moi mettre ton nom d'un côté et de l'autre. Ouais.